हेलो क्लास फाइव स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑफलाइन वर्चुअल क्लास। सो इन लास्ट चैप्टर, इन चैप्टर वन, व्हाट वी टॉक अबाउट इज कंप्यूटर ओवरव्यू। एंड इन कंप्यूटर ओवरव्यू वी डिस्कस अबाउट द ओरिजिन, हाउ इट केम, द नेम ऑफ द कंप्यूटर एंड हाउ इट वर्क्स, इट्स डेफिनेशन, ओके, एंड द बेसिक पार्ट ऑफ द कंप्यूटर लाइक कीबोर्ड, माउस, समथिंग लाइक दैट, एंड अदर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द कंप्यूटर like it's very fast, intelligent, it accurate, something like that, and the field of work where it uses normally, school, colleges, okay, bank, hospital, something like this. Now in this chapter 2, we are starting chapter 2 today, we are talking about this hardware and software. Okay, most of you already know what is hardware and software, but in detail we'll talk about it. Okay, before starting this chapter 2, hardware and software, first thing you should know is what computer is made up of, what are the components that makes a computer, okay, what are the parts and its uses that makes the computer, and how these individual components, parts works. Okay, you should know this all in the beginning. So let's start. So first thing is hardware. Okay, computer mostly has two parts, okay, they are hardware and software, as you know. So in the picture also you can see down there, there is software and hardware, and in by the picture you can see that clearly that hardware means the physical parts of the computer and software means the parts which makes the computer works, that is called software. Okay, there are two components. For example, in hardware there are keyboard, mouse, monitor, CPU, webcam and so on, there are lots of, okay. And hardware is also divided into two parts, one is internal, which is inside this CPU, okay, another is external, like this keyboard, mouse, webcam, scanner, these are the external. And software is what that makes the hardware works. Okay, for example, operating system, OS means operating system, Microsoft Word, Excel, PaintBrush, likewise. Now let's go in detail in computer hardware. So what is computer hardware actually? It is a physical part of the system which makes the computer complete. Complete means it makes the computer work properly. It can be touched and felt physically. Okay, all the hardwares which we have, we can touch it and feel it, like the keyboard, mouse, monitor, like those. Okay, another is hardware. Normally there are different types of hardware, I have already told. Okay, some of the hardwares are like this. Actually they are categorized into four category, but the one is in exceptional. So the first one, let's read the first one, input hardware. All input devices are input hardware which helps to give data and instruction to the computer. Okay, all the input devices like keyboard, mouse, okay, and scanner, joystick, those all are input devices, and these input devices are input hardware. Okay, and these input devices helps to give the data and instructions. Second one is processing hardware. So for the example, this picture, look at the picture, these are the input devices. Next one is processing hardware. CPU is a processing hardware. Okay, CPU, central processing unit, CPU means central processing unit, is a processing hardware. Here CPU means a small chip found in the motherboard which processes the data given from input hardware. So when you say CPU, you think about this, the big box CPU. Okay, think about this big box CPU casing. But actually CPU is the small one, this one, this chip is called CPU actually. In actual sense, this chip is called CPU. Okay, it does all the processing, whatever we type or click, it goes to this chip and it will process. Okay, this is called processing hardware, this chip is called processing hardware. Next one is the output hardware. All the output devices, look at here in this picture, all the output devices, like this monitor, printer is here, plotter is here, okay, and speaker is here, and projector is here, these all are output devices. So whatever output device you have, those all are called output hardware. And the next one is, and all output devices are output hardware which helps to display result. Okay, this all output devices helps to display result as information after processing done by the CPU. When CPU does the processing, it gives the output or result through these output devices. Okay, next one is memory or storage hardware. Memory hardware are internal memory such as RAM and ROM, whereas storage hardware are external storage such as SDD, hard disk, CD, DVD, pen drive, etc. Okay, whenever you do something, you give some input, it will be processed and displays through the output device. That is the straight thing, input, process, output. But whenever you need those things later on in future, if you need those things, you need to save those things. So this all the information will be the raw data or process data will be stored in this memory hardware or storage hardware. Alright, like inside there are two types of memory also. Normally we can say that internal memory, that is kept inside the motherboard. Okay, another is external memory that you can see outside, like CD, DVD, hard disk, pen drive, something like that. Okay, and next one is, last one is other hardware. Some hardwares are not based in input processing output. They are exceptional, and those are other, like power cable, modem, data cables, casing, motherboard, big casing, okay, and which supports above hardware to run. Okay, this other hardware supports all this input processing output and memory hardware. Okay, understood? This one, there are some pictures also I have given. So what is this? This is a CPU chip. What is this? This is a memory or storage hardware. And below here, what is this? This is other hardwares that supports the above hardwares. Another is this input and output devices. Okay, this is all about the hardware. Now let's go to the software part. Okay, computer software. Look at here, computer software. It is a logical part of the computer system which cannot be touched. Okay, these software cannot be touched like hardware, like keyboard we can touch, mouse we can touch, but we cannot touch this software part. Okay, how? Because if there is a YouTube, can you touch YouTube? If there is a Microsoft Word, can you touch Microsoft Word? No. If you touch on the screen, that means you are touching on the monitor, not the software. So it is just a logical part of the computer system that cannot be touched. So what is this software actually? The meaning is, it is a set of instruction that perform specific task. Okay, set of instruction means do this, that perform the particular task. Like if you talk about the paintbrush, it has some instruction. That means that instruction does some specific task, that is painting, drawing, okay, coloring, then like those only. And if you talk about the Microsoft Word, it has some instruction that we can do is to complete a task, that we can do is type, make it bold, big letter, small letter, make it italics, keep some pictures, something like that only, not more than that. Okay, so it has a set of instructions that perform only specific task, that is called a program. So if those all programs are grouped together, that is called software. Okay, inside this Microsoft Word or paintbrush, if you choose only to color, that is a coloring program. If you choose only to draw, that is drawing only, sketching only program. But if you make it together, then it became a software. It became a paintbrush software. Alright? So the main function of software is what? Software tells hardware what to do. Just keep in your mind that when you buy a hardware, then without keeping the software, that hardware won't work. That hardware is useless. So software tells those hardwares what to do. Alright, next one is, so software is mainly, there are two categories. Okay, one is system software, another is application software. And system software, now let's be clear about the system software. System software means like this operating system. See here, Windows XP, Windows Vista, Windows 7, this is Android, this is Windows 10, this is Linux, this is Apple, Mac OS. Okay, so let's go to the system software. System software, it is a set of set of one or more programs that directs the internal operation and makes the ready to use by the user. So what system software does is it makes us to use the computer ready. So okay, when you boot the computer, when you start the computer, we just sit back and wait for what? Desktop. Yes or no? So that desktop is a system software. Clear? Operating system. An example is operating system. If your computer has Windows 7, then Windows 7 desktop will come. Until desktop will come, can you open Microsoft Word or PaintBrush? No, we cannot open. That means first when you turn on the computer, the system software will be activated and makes us ready to use it. Okay, that is the system software. And that system software controls and manages the operation of the computer system. Whatever computer you have, so it controls the computer, all the system of the computer, whether mouse is working properly or not, hard disk is working properly properly or not. Sometimes something, if RAM is damaged or hard disk is damaged, then message will be given by the system software that this part is not working, that part is not working, like that. That's why system software is very much important. So operating systems are the system software. As you know that, as I told you here, all the operating system are the system software. Okay. So for example, Windows 7, Windows 10, Linux, Mac OS, Android, there are lots of hundreds of more also. So next one, let's go to the next one, and that is application software. So application software are those software which we use, which user use. Okay, like look at here in the picture. Here is Photoshop is here, Word is here, Microsoft Word is here, your VLC player is here, PDF reader is there, Chrome is here, Internet Explorer is. These all are application software. Application that we use, that we user use. Those are the application software. Design, it is designed for users like us, which works according to our need. Okay, these all applications are works according to our need. Okay, it is created by a company or individual. So this software we can create. If you know how to create a software, you can create also, or a group of people or a company can create for you whatever you need. So for example, PaintBrush, Word, Excel, Photoshop, Chrome, etc. Okay, understood? So this chapter is very much easy. So only few things you need to know. Now let's go on to the exercise. Let's do the exercise. First one. Okay, page number 5 or 6, or let's see, page number 26. Okay, fill in the blanks. There are some words over here. Okay, A number, dot 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 are the physical part of the computer. What are the physical part of the computer? Hardware. Okay, first one is hardware is the physical part of the computer. Likewise, do B, C, D. Let's go on B also. Dot 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 are the logical component of components that directs the hardware what to do and how to do. Okay, who tells what to do? Software. Okay, software are the logical components. Likewise, do CDE. Next one is true and false. Let's see. Application software are designed as per the user's need. Okay, isn't it? Only the system software are fixed and understand by the system, but application software are designed as per our need. If you want to make any software, you just give some point. I want like this software, and the software company or the programmer can design. So application software are designed as per the user's need. It is true. Likewise, do B, C, D. Let's go to number 3. Question number 3. This is a question answer. So all of these things you have to do in book, and take a photo and submit to me. Okay, homework, as a homework. What are the major component of the computer? It's obvious. The major component of the component of the computer are hardware and software. Okay. What is computer hardware? As you know, as discussed before, hardware is just a physical part of the computer. Okay. For example, keyboard, mouse, like that. Hardware also, there are 4 types of hardware. You just write on. Likewise, do C, D, E, F, G. Up to S is here, question answer. Now let's go for this single word, a physical part of the computer. Okay, the program that makes the computer work, the device, you just see it there, answer are there. So next one is full form, RAM, you know it, I think, random access memory, ROM, CD-ROM, DVD, and ALU. Okay, in CPU there are two types of function happens, that is CU and ALU. CU is control unit, ALU is arithmetic logic unit. Okay, these are the homework for you, and do it properly and send it to me. All right. Okay, thank you for the class 5. Bye bye.